feels like we're playing in front of family, to be honest. Yeah, I mean, because we've been here, you know, a few times, probably since the beginning of our careers as Common Kings. And so we've grown up with a lot of the people in the crowd, a lot of people backstage, Pato especially, you know. So, yeah, I mean, it feels like playing in front of family.
I just love New Zealand music in general. You know, we take something from overseas and then we make it our own. And, you know, New Zealand reggae bands are like such great examples of that. They don't try and be anything they're not. They just take this influence and then we transform it, we chuck it in the boiler, we mix it up and something unique and Kiwi comes out. And I love that.
I think reggae is it's a laid back thing. It's a groove thing. It's a people's movement. That's what that is, you know, and the music just has that pulse.
We're not selfish about reggae because it's for the globe, it's for the world, you know, so the growth is always great.
I definitely think the energy is different at One Love. That people come like with a lot of concerts people come along to watch, but I feel like at One Love they come to participate. That's real cool.
Yeah. That the crowd is part of the performance. Yeah, we're counting on the crowd as much as they're counting on us.
I can never get enough of Aotearoa, you know? I think even if I was to participate in any other One Love, I think this is special for me, just because me personally, I like to keep very rooted with culture. Not only for myself being Samoan, but for my friends who are Tongan. I like to empower them in who they are and hopes that we recognize our culture and our identity. And that's who we are, you know?
Well, I mean, we can look back at it and see, like, you know, Bob Marley with his different styles of music, different topics and whatever, and seeing the powerful impact it has on certain things, you know, politically, etc. And I mean, reggae music at the end of the day can be rebellious, but it's to reach the main goal of peace and prosperity, so. I don't wanna kill the fire, and I want you to live your life, I want you to stay, but if you leave, better believe me when I say.
Festivals different for me. I mean, it's halfway across the world, first of all, you know. You see everybody enjoying themselves, even if they don't really know the artists or the songs or anything, they just embrace every culture that's out here right now. It's special.
Particularly given I'm of all the iwi here, so it's a really huge thing for us to host this kaupapa. And of course all the people that come through, that roll through, that bring economy into Tauranga and bring it into the Bay of Plenty, and they bring their love with it, so I'm all about that.
I mean, you know, we've played festivals in, you know, Europe, Germany, UK. It has that same vibe, but at home, you know, we feel home here.
Hey, what's up everybody? Pato here. Thank you. I love you all for coming to the festival and keep supporting us every year. So loud for the 4 years in the road. We are coming to Gold Coast next week. One Love is going worldwide. The Aotearoa movement reggae is gonna go expanding. See you in Gold Coast. And we're gonna be in two different countries very soon. Aotearoa reggae music.
At this time, I'd like to take a break for our local sponsors. Shout out to Green Room, 100% natural, low in sugar, made in Aotearoa, only in Green Room.